some progress, but way too slow. Is that your take on what's going on with NAFTA right now?
Yeah. It seems like recently, maybe the last week, it's gotten a little bit better. There's a little bit more optimism that things are beginning to look like there's a solution. Up until then, it was looking pretty bad. There's still a lot of pessimism. You know, what the U.S. has put on the table is pretty aggressive. Autos, rules of origin, the dispute settlements, the five-year sunset, I think, is off the table now. But I'm a little bit more optimistic today. It's interesting, you know, we have different problems with Canada than we do with Mexico. And you could see a scenario where you come out of this, maybe not with NAFTA, but with two FTAs. I don't know. But that's a possibility. But it's getting a little bit better, and I think the administration is going to turn its sights towards China. And having two trade battles at the same time is difficult.
Explain the timing a little bit, particularly with the Mexican elections coming up. There's some people saying that as a practical matter, if you don't get this done by March, which doesn't seem that likely, you're going to have to put it off until the fall till you get through those elections. Does that sound right to you from what you know of that country?
Yeah, that's right. I mean, if you get it done by March, that means it's a pretty fair deal. If it is viewed that Mexico got a raw deal and that Mexico was pushed around, then the July elections could be very detrimental for the U.S. Because it's interesting, the person who's running ahead in the polls is a anti-American, far-left wing candidate. So we could create the conditions to put that man in power. So we have to be very careful. And if it's viewed that we pushed Mexico around, you know, the national pride may be not included in the trade agreement, but it's really there and it exists.